Γεια σας παιδιά, καλησπέρα, η Ιωάννα εδώ και στο σημερινό βίντεο έχουμε μαζί μας τον Ρικάρντας από την Hive Finance και είμαι πάρα πολύ χαρούμενη γιατί όχι μόνο είναι αποκλειστική αυτή η συνέντευξη που τη δίνει στο κανάλι των Financial Greeks για πρώτη φορά στην Ελλάδα, αλλά είναι και μια τόσο καινούργια και τόσο innovative πλατφόρμα που χαίρομαι πάρα πολύ. Εννοείται, έχουμε link στην περιγραφή αυτού του βίντεο όπως και στο pin comment και πραγματικά το εκτιμούμε αν χρησιμοποιήσετε το link μας, εάν σε περίπτωση θέλετε να επενδύσετε στην πλατφόρμα της Hive, το εκτιμούμε πολύ, γιατί με αυτόν τον τρόπο βοηθάτε πάρα πολύ το κανάλι να μεγαλώσει. Τώρα θα αρχίσω να μιλάω στα αγγλικά. So, switching in English, Ρικάρντας, first of all, thank you so much for having you here with us. It's really important for us because the thing that we say all the time when it comes to investments is that we need to have transparency. And for the head of one of such an innovative project as Hive Finance to appear with his face, with his ideas and his words to our audience, I think that's the most transparent someone can ask for. So thank you for
Absolutely.
Being here.
A pleasure, Ioana. Really pleasure. And great to meet all the financial Greeks. I'm really happy to have a floor meeting today with you. And I'm really open and transparent to answer all of your questions, Ioana. Feel free to ask.
Okay, I'm not going to be easy on you. I'm going to be hard. So let's dig in. Okay, Ricardas, why did you start Hive Finance? What was the reason that urged you to create such an incredible project?
I had a very natural reason where we arrived to this business model of P2P funding, and I think it's at large, it was influenced by, you know, my previous career record. So over the past 15 years, you know, I was working in the, generally in securing the investment funding for the business, you know, and I was working, you know, with the risk capital funds, with the mezzanines, with the investment bankers, high net worths. It was always about chasing the investments, you know, in order to allocate them for the growth. Usually it was a medium, large multinational corporates with the big ambition, you know, to scale in the international markets. And I was the one, you know, in the role to secure the sufficiency in funding. You know, what I saw in the market that all the classical guys, all the investment funds and risk capitals, you know, and the wealthy investors, on one hand, they're quite slow in the decision making process. And, you know, some of those cases and good business investment cases with the good and interesting returns would never see the daylight. Unfortunately, they would just stay, you know, in the dust. So, you know, I had a fantastic opportunity when I met my business partner, Andrus, who is also, you know, a globalist. He's a global investment, you know, manager. He's got his own business in GPS tracking and software solution business in five continents. We met together and I remember we were discussing about the same challenges we face. Capital sufficiency, slow decision making, and the thing that the digital brings for that is that it's always about the speed. It's always about the investor's ability to make a direct decision, you know, to evaluate the risk appetite, to see what's on the table, you know, right, and to do their own investment decision. So this is where I think it was our initial idea was born, that we say, you know, we need to establish a Hive Finance. We're both ultimate beneficiaries, you know, of Hive Finance, and we need to do the crowdfund. So it was that point where we arrived.
It came together. Okay, that's really interesting because Ricardas, being a businesswoman myself and having four companies right now that I'm running, I know how crucial it is to find right business partners and to also have access to capital when the timing of the market is right. Because like you said, if I get funding for the idea that is now trending and I want to ride the wave now, if I get funding a year from now, it's not gonna be good use for me. So the idea will fail. So I definitely agree with you on that. And I'm actually thankful that you built Hive Finance. I'm going to ask you later on if you are planning to sponsor companies in Greece, but I'm not there yet. Ricardas, I understand that you just launched the project, right? And I know from what I have seen already that we already have the first results of the platform. So can you tell us what is the situation situation there?
Well, this morning I've actually sent a big thanks to all of our team and in our group, corporate meeting, by saying a lot of thanks that we've, within just the last 3 weeks of August, we have achieved tremendous KPIs. You know, first of all, we've entered the P2P, the competitive P2P market. We've managed, to launch with the two products same time. So that's a consumer and business product. We've also had received a very positive reflections from the professional invest P2P investment bloggers, because we had quite a number of interview rounds as we have them now. The first evaluations gave us actually very positive mood, and that gives us a promise that we're doing the right thing. Within the August, we've achieved the first milestone of over 100,000 euros of loan funding through P2P platform. I know that there is a far way to go above and into the table of the rankings, in the P2P market. But we're ready for that, because we're ready with the global scale, and I believe that we will grow pretty much fast.
And also, Ricardas, like we always say, both me and Chris, that we are together in Financial Europeans now, we say that even the biggest goal you can achieve by doing one step at a time. So if the milestone was set to 100K for August and you achieved it, and even more, so, this is pure progress. So that's all that matters.
Indeed. But actually, we were even more conservative. We didn't count on such a good progress from the very first few weeks, because we were still thinking that, we will need to do some extra milestones, But I think the professionalism behind the team, our knowledge and experience in P2P market, it gave us a synergy. And I think the big majority of our investors, the first coming investors, were actually the guys from, from our native field. So, which is also very important. The friends, the investors with whom we did our previous business ventures, they entrusted us immediately because they know us, and they did their first investments too. So that's very, very positive.
That's a good sign, of course. But Ricardas, this actually brings me to my next question. So why should someone put money on Hive Finance? I mean, what is your experience as a team in the field? I mean, I know that you talked a bit about your experience, but I really want to have a clear idea of why we should trust Hive Finance as a team.
I think it's a very fair question. I think it's an ultimate question, to all of the investors. And speaking, from the top, from the shareholding, both me and the finance, Andrus is in technology. This is where the perfect match begin. We both have experience, a long-term experience in our field, of expertise. Andrus has a family software house, running a big business in software for many years, starting, his study years. And we built the same, philosophy when we onboarded our first team members. For instance, when we launched, our first micro lending company in Poland, we onboarded professional team with the long years experience in digital online lending, with the best practices in risk management. So that, I think, is a key to success from our perspective, that first of all, we have a huge experience and all of us are knowledgeable. Even, for instance, in P2P platform, our operations, marketing team, all of them are coming from the previous biggest P2P platforms, in European society. So they know what to do. They have a track record. And, it saves so much of a time, to scale the business and to do the professional process from the number one day, that I think this is the biggest driver. And I think another key importance that would differentiate us a lot from the other platforms, is that we have a technology solution which is working in a ready-tested environment. Actually, we have two key products, from the solution perspective. One is the micro-lending software, which has a track record, specifically in Polish market. It has a track record of over 10 years, being tested in the real-time environment. We also have a very sophisticated, actually, we are one of the leaders in Polish market, which is working with the process fully automated in terms of scorecarding our customers. It has a huge big data, artificial intelligence tool, which manages the big data on the decision-making engine. And I think that's also what makes us unique. And I think this this is what we're going to use for this, for our future scale in all the next geographies, you know, but because the software is important. Same with the P2P platform. We started with a product which is tested environment, and we are now developing it and making it even more user friendly as we go. So I think this is the key tools for the success that we are using.
Okay, that's actually very interesting, because it's one thing to know finance and it's another thing to know technology, and when these things are combined, I think it's the optimal. I'm really interested in watching the next steps and seeing if the milestones are there and if they're completed and how it goes. But actually, this is something that truly differentiates you from other peer-to-peer platforms. Before we invited you here for the interview, our team of experts did a heavy due diligence, of course, right? We don't just speak with anybody. And it was amazing for us that we genuinely saw that the software you use, you know it. You don't just rent it from somewhere in order to just enter the peer-to-peer world of Europe. For us, that was one of the, you know, green flags. We said, okay, let's go. Let's hear these guys out. Okay, Ricardas, what are the next milestones? Like, what is coming next for High Finance in terms of plans or new products? I don't know, venture loans. What can you give us? I mean, I understand that you cannot tell us all, but can you tell us something?
That's the best question I ever have. And I really love those type of questions. What are the next future plans? Because we're ambitious, you know, both myself and my partner in business, Andrius, we're both global type, you know, of the business makers. Andrius is running the, you know, his GPS, which is in 5 continents, you know, he has a big multinational team. So we now, we always there with the global growth, you know, and indeed, we have two main streams in our strategy focus. One is the geographical, so that comes into 3 next stages. First is Europe, second is Africa's, and then because it's on the same timeline. And then the third, we're going to do Asia's, but Asia's will come in the end of 2023. So we'll have to be patient, because the homeworks for the Asia needs to be done properly, you know, to enter into the huge market, huge business opportunities, but we want to prepare it properly. So that's when it comes to geographical, you know, diversification. And I think it will be exciting for our investors at the end of the day, because I'm in P2P investors for many years myself too. I invest, and every time when I approach the P2P platform, I look for the possibility to diversify geographically and then product-wise too. So the two key items on the table. Same with us. The second stream, besides the geographical diversification and scale and growth, we will also introduce the roadmap of our future products in P2P platform as well. So we've started with 2 products at the go live, which is consumer and business. One is a short product for the investors, and I think it's very attractive. It's attractive for myself too, which is a 30 days classical consumer lending product. The second is a business loan for those who are willing to invest into a bit longer perspective, 180 days. It's not too long. It's still not something which I've just had a few discussions with my investment fund guys, and they say, yeah, you know, your attractiveness is that your guys creating a money market, you know, short money market gives a flexibility to manage your own funds. We cannot offer our investors such luxury, you know, because the funds are always about at least 12 months or even 2 years or 3 years investment. Right. Mm-hmm. And what is for sure, they would never offer such a high yield for the investment too. So, you know, coming back to the products, we started with the simple business loan at the start. And the next thing what we're going to have in the roadmap very shortly is we're going to offer green loans. And I think...
Green loans?
True.
Okay. I mean, Ricardas, I'm sorry to interrupt, but when I hear green, I'm happy. Because, you know, money is good, but after a while, you cannot breathe money. We need to care about the environment as well. And I mean, it's really ethical. So, okay, please tell us a bit more about this.
Financing of sustainable business is our key target on the table. And, you know, I think it's the key strategy for the entire Europe we face, you know, because all over the news, we see what's going on with the macroeconomics. We will definitely need to reshuffle our energy consumption, you know, priorities. And for that, the green green funding, the green projects are currently, I think, that will be the biggest target for all of the investors in their portfolios. Either a small investors, multi-kind investors, or the high net worths, all of those guys are seeking to invest their funds into the green. So that will be only one of the products. Another one, I think it's again, it came very naturally when we were discussing with Andrews, you know, we had a business customers, usually the e-commerce driven businesses, and that was coming back to the, you know, the COVID times when a lot of last mile service providers, you know, were booming because we were all, everybody of us were sitting at home, right?
Yeah.
So we were getting food, we were getting the clothes, we're getting everything at home. So these were the customers in Benelux countries, Germany, Poland, the big markets, which were approaching us in our parallel business in GPS tracking. They're buying big volumes of GPS trackers and software solution in it. And they were saying, guys, we are beginners, we are startups, we are buying the big volumes of your GPS trackers, you know, but we need a funding because we don't have a sufficiency in our equities. None of the banks would give us that opportunity. Can you fund us? Of course, we did it. We funded it out of our equity, you know, and pocket. We said, buy now, pay later. You know, we did that ourselves. And then we said, you know, why don't we offer this to our P2P investors? If we invested into this business, you know, we're pretty sure that those returns and those high yields are also with the security on top because we pledged the GPS tracker, which is a very demanding product. You know, we can offer this product to the whole society in Europe, you know. So that's coming up as well. Yeah.
Okay.
That's coming.
And Ricardas, to be honest, this in Africa that is also developing now, and also the green projects again in Africa. I mean, I'm not even touching Asia because honestly, I don't know the market so well like I know Europe and Africa because I have worked in both continents with various projects. Africa and green projects is a must.
You're absolutely right.
Here. Yeah. So Ricardas, what about Greece? Is Greece in any of the plans? I mean, you can say no, we will not get offended. We know by now, yeah. But I have to ask as a Greek.
And I'm happy that you're asking because indeed, you know, we have a very straightforward strategy and plan. You know, we were always doing the business in the large countries. You know, although we're coming together with Andrews, we're coming from the small countries. You know, we have a 3 million population almost. But in fact, we were doing business in 5 continents in the countries which where the population is at least 10 million plus, you know. So the answer is that we definitely follow those countries in the European market which have a big scalable markets and the big opportunities for consumer because we all of us P2P investors, we must admit that, you know, the most attractive product is short to invest. Yes. And it's the high yield. And it's not about only the high yield that we offer to our P2P investors and we are able to offer it because we earn high yields. It's not a secret that in those markets of consumer lending, the yields are a couple of hundred of percent per year, you know. This is where we, you know, we generate profits. This is where we build the equity reserve, you know, to manage the risks and defaults. And that's why we're naturally focusing to the big markets and industries.
I understand that this provides a lot of security for the people that will actually put money in your platform. But I really hope that Greece will, even being a small country, will at some point be an equal to those bigger countries, bigger economies. You know, it's my wishful thinking, but being from a small country as well, you understand me. And I think you know the feeling.
True.
Okay, Ricardas, I really think that I have everything I need, but I need just one small clarification. I know from an investor's point of view, because I'm investing heavily in peer-to-peer for many years now, but genuinely the last 2 years, I increased my portfolio in peer-to-peer investing more. So the only problem I always have is that I want to have a really direct communication with the platform. So I need you to tell us about customer support. I mean, I know that I will ask in the end of the video, the guys that saw the video, if they have any questions, they can write below or they can reach out to your platform. What is your perception of customer support and what can people expect?
Joanna, I was born in the customer support society, you know. I've started in the big four. So, you know, I've naturally have an installation in my ethical standard, you know, to have a full reflection on what's going on, the, you know, in our our business in front of our investors because we are managing their own funds. So they have entrusted us, you know, to manage them, and we need to be fully responsive, and we need to, you know, respond to every single question, no matter what type of it. And I'm happy to know, I'm confident, because this is what kind of a team we have built around. All of them are coming from the society where we know the drill of reporting, not only in our, you know, corporate governance model, because we also, you know, we have responsibilities to report, you know, the performance up to the shareholding level and our stakeholders as well. But we're also always supportive. And what you can expect at least from us is that the regular replies to any kind of questions, either operational support or the financials, we're fully open and transparent on that.
Perfect. That's really important, Ricardas. Before we go, I know that we have a bonus thing that is taking place until the 23rd of September. Is that correct?
You're absolutely right. We do have
and I am going important to mention. Of course, and I am going to write it in the description so that people can read it in Greek, but yeah. I would like a small comment from you also on that, because it's really important. You know, if people join now, what do they get in regards to join later?
All the financial Greeks, please join us very quickly, guys, because we have exclusive period of time, extra 1% on top of the luxury interest rates we already offered, which is currently we have 12 plus 1. So plus 1 is the extra what we are offering at the moment till 23rd of September. Please utilize it, because I believe this will give you a good extra earnings on your investment. So 13% for the consumer and 15% for the business. And to spice it up on top, Joanna, we very shortly, my colleague will introduce also the loyalty program, and it will be also very much attractive for our investors. So stay tuned.
Okay, we will definitely stay tuned. Ricardas, thank you once again so much for being here with us. I really, really appreciate it. I appreciate your honesty. I appreciate that even when you said no, you know, you had the motives and you had the strategy correct, and you answered without hesitation to all our questions. I really hope that people will write more questions in your comments and they will reach out to your customer support. I'm really looking forward to host you back here in a year from now, let's say, to see where Hype Finance is and how your guys progressing and skyrocketing.
Fantastic.
I really think it's best. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Anna. It was a great pleasure, and I'm really looking forward for our next interview. Thank you so much.
Παιδιά, αυτή ήταν η συνέντευξή μας με τον Ρικάρντας της Hype Finance. Νομίζω πραγματικά ότι τα είπαμε όλα και απαντήσαμε στις περισσότερες ερωτήσεις που πραγματικά ήρθαν στο δικό μας μυαλό. Αλλά γράψτε μας στα σχόλια, εννοείται, οποιαδήποτε άλλη ερώτηση έχετε ή αν κάτι δεν σας φάνηκε ότι απαντήθηκε σωστά, για να το απαντήσουμε και αυτό. Είναι πάρα πολύ σημαντικό, ειδικά όταν μία προσπάθεια ξεκινάει τώρα. Και εννοείται, όπως είπαμε, υπάρχει bonus για αυτή την περίοδο μέχρι τις 23/9, μέχρι τις 23 Σεπτεμβρίου, 1% έξτρα σε μια επένδυση που ούτως ή άλλως θα κάναμε. Και σαφώς αυτό δεν είναι επενδυτική συμβουλή, πρέπει να κάνετε το δικό σας due diligence, πρέπει να κάνετε τη δική σας έρευνα, αλλά πείτε μας στα σχόλια πώς σας φαίνεται η πλατφόρμα. Ευχαριστώ πολύ, είμαι η Ιωάννα και τα λέμε στο επόμενο βίντεο. Φιλιά πολλά!